In this video, I'm going to show you how to build a robot on Browse AI. Let's jump into it. All right, the first step is to go to your robots page in your Browse AI account. From this page, we'll see two options: extract structured data and monitor site changes. In this case, we're going to go with monitor site changes. The first piece of data you need is the origin URL. Which website do you want to scrape? In my case, I'm going to go to a used camera website, and I want to give myself a good deal on some Sony cameras. So I'll copy this URL, go back to Browse AI, and paste that in right there. I don't need to log in, so I won't check that box. And then I'll click Start Recording Task. Now a new window pops up. Let's click OK, Understood. And now the robot's watching my cursor, waiting for me to show it what to do. So let's click on the head here, and then Capture List. And then I'm going to scroll down to which part of this page I want to capture. So once you see the list items, 1, 2, 3, let's click there. I want the image URL, so let's click on that, and we'll select Capture Image URL. I want the name, of course, so let's click on that. I want the price, capture visible text. And lastly, I'll go up one level here to the full item to get the link, capture link. Now, there's options above there. I'm going to press enter to finish and name each of these. Image, enter. Name, enter. Price, enter. And link, enter. All right, perfect. Now we've got a chance to review the captured list. At a quick glance, everything looks good to me. So let's name this Sony cameras. The maximum number of rows I want is 36. And I don't have any more items to load, so I won't choose one of these other items, but depending on your website, you may have to choose one of these. I will choose there are no more items to load, and then capture list. Now we'll click finish recording. Let's give the robot a name. I like to use something descriptive, like monitorkeh.com for Sony cameras, and we'll click save. Now we'll set up a monitor. I'm going to do it every single day. I'm not particular on what time of day, so anytime is fine. And I do want to be notified by email. And we'll save this. Now, if we scroll down, you can see a list similar to the one we just had. And you can download a CSV if you'd like to use the data in Google Sheets or Excel, for example. Now let's scroll down to the bottom of the page. We can click Yes, looks good to approve it. No, let me retrain the robot if it's not quite right. No, report an issue to contact our support team or delete the robot. We're going to click Yes, looks good. From the Run Task page, we can do something interesting. Let's delete this URL. Go to the same website, but a different page with lenses on it. Copy this link and bring it back over. We don't have to train a separate robot. We just paste that link and run the task. Because the pages are so similar, this robot can do the same job, but on a different page. Now, if we scroll down, you can see these are lenses. These are not cameras. And this is one way Browse AI makes your life easier. Let's go back to the Run Task page. Bulk Run Tasks is another time-saving feature. You can download a sample CSV, add your own URLs to it, and re-upload it to run the robot on all of those URLs at once. Next, let's go to the Monitor tab at the top here. We've got one default monitor that we set up. I want to create another monitor. But in this case, I'm going to go to yet another page on that same website. I'm looking for Olympus cameras. So I will go to that page on the website, click the URL, and bring it over. So once again, I don't have to train our separate robot on that page, just a different monitor. And now both of them will run. In the Integrate tab, you can automatically send data to Google Sheets, Zapier, Webhooks, Airtable, etc. Another time saver and a great way to supercharge your workflows. Let's check the Settings tab. We've got the default input parameters section up here. We can change your URL and number of items. We can scroll down and hover over each of these little bubbles, and it'll explain what these options do. And we can delete our robot. In this case, I'm not going to do that. I have one last thing to show. I want to briefly explain tasks and credits. You can see this one used 1.20 credits. Up here, we'll see one credit per task includes 10 list items. 0.1 credits per additional list item. So this used 1.2 credits, because as you can see, there were 12 list items. Now, if we go back to the dashboard, you can see this is the robot that uses the monitors to run tasks that use credits. Hope you found this video helpful and look forward to seeing you in the next one.